Are you governor or not?
Mr. Douglas?
If you tricked me out of my cell, you're going to have Buckley's chance of getting the other women out of theirs.
All right. But I won't have Smith back here.
Mrs. Powell, do you have anything to say?
Not at the moment, Mrs. Davidson.
Good. Now that I am returned as governor of this prison, I shall make a bargain with you. If you get the women to behave responsibly, then I shall work towards restoring the privileges we introduced before.
And what about B?
She will remain at Barnhurst for the time being. I shall review that situation later. Agreed?
Yeah, I guess so, thanks.
Well, we had to compromise. But Mrs. Davidson is back as the governor, and she has promised to get our privileges back for us.
But what about B?
No, I'm afraid that Douglas is determined she will stay where she is.
Oh, bastard.
No, it might be all right. Davidson did say she'd try and get her back for us.
But if Douglas has said no, she can't do anything because he's the boss, isn't he?
I wouldn't be too sure of that. I mean, Mrs. Davidson is pretty determined. And, I think with a little gentle persuasion from us, we might have B back here in no time at all. You awake, love?
Yeah.
Want a cup of coffee before they set us loose for the day?
Oh, okay.
I wonder how Bee's getting on at Barnhurst.
I reckon she'll be missing her mates.
Yeah, well, if our plan works, she'll be back here soon.
Yeah, pretty dull without Bee here, isn't it?
You can say that again. She sure makes the place tick, huh? Well, I hope everyone does their bit, because it's not going to work if everyone doesn't try.
Well, I reckon Phyllis and Hazel will be okay. I don't know about Margo. I mean, she may not want to get involved, you know, because of going to court this morning.
Yeah, isn't that shocking? You have to wait a fortnight for your sentence. I mean, all that time, hanging over your head, not knowing what you're going to get.
Yeah, well, even if she doesn't help, I reckon the rest of us will be all right.
Of course it will.
Well, do you reckon things are going to pick up around here now Davo's come back as governor?
I hope so, love. And once Bee's back, everything will be back to normal. You'll see.
Yeah, well, I can't wait to get out of this joint. You know, I really need a shower. Get real grotty after 3 days without one.
Yeah, I was meaning to talk to you about that, love. You are a bit on the nose.
Oh! Morning.
Good morning, Cole.
Well, let's hope it is a good morning.
Yeah, know what you mean.
Well, are we over the trouble now?
Or do you think they're planning something else?
It's up to us to make sure that they don't step out of line again. We've got to keep on their backs, not give them the slightest leeway.
Yes, I agree. I think we've got to watch their every move. Mind you, the junior staff aren't too happy about things.
Well, I'm not surprised. The very fact that the women got off scot-free wouldn't make them feel any more secure.
Yeah. And if Mrs. Davidson's going to introduce new schemes that just involves more work, she'll have no backing at all.
What do you think, Jim?
Well, why ask me? I'm just here to be pushed around by the department.
Yes, I think you have been treated badly. If I were you, I wouldn't put up with it.
The thing that really worries me is that with Smith gone, the women could well be jockeying for the position of top dog.
Well, at the first sign of trouble, we've got to be ready for them.
Well, come on, that's it. Let's get into it.
I was wishing I could have stayed at home today.
Yes, I feel the same.
Hear about the plan?
Yeah.
You're going to be in it?
Better not. I'm due in court soon. Better keep my nose clean till then.
Yeah. What do you think you'll get?
Could be pretty stiff. 3 years, probably. 4 or 5, the judge is a tough one.
Yeah, it'd be a bit much, huh?
Yeah. Thought of 5 more years in this joint's enough to send me right round the twist.
Hey, what do you reckon you lot are up to?
Yeah, we were first.
Well, we're first now.
That's right. Want to make anything of it?
All right, break it up. What's going on?
Nothing, Mr. Fletcher. Is there, Lizzie?
No, nothing at all.
You two throwing your weight around. If you want to stay out of solitary, you'd better forget it.
All right, Hunt, down the end of the queue.
Why?
Because I told you to, that's why. Kent, you get behind Burns. And behave yourself.
How's it going? Looks like Hunt and Kent are trying to move for the top position.
We better keep our eye on those two.
Right. Listen, Gaffney's peace escort should be here in a minute.
Gaffney. You haven't got time for that. Go and change. You're due in court.
Oh, you might as well give her a time to have a brekkie.
Yeah, we haven't had very much to eat lately, Miss Bennett.
You chose to starve yourselves. Now, hurry up, Gaffney.
Good luck, Margo.
Yeah, you'll be right, love.
Yeah, go on, Margo. Good luck,
mate. Good luck.
Thank you.
Well, Margo, I just want to wish you luck.
Thanks, Mrs. Morris. Never had much of that.
I hope they're not too hard on you.
Depends on what mood the judge is in, doesn't it? 4 or 5 years, I reckon.
Well, she can't expect to get off scot-free.
I can't help but feel sorry for her.
Oh, I don't know why you should, Meg, after what she and her boyfriend did to you.
Well, that wasn't Margot's doing.
Oh, now, Meg, she was Bradshaw's accomplice and attacked an officer. I'll be surprised if the punishment isn't pretty severe.
Probably will be.
Trying to burn me, you bitch!
What are you talking about? I don't know what you're talking about.
You're just trying to put me out of action. I know what you're trying to do, Jenny. Cut that out.
Shut up.
Yeah.
Quiet. Now, what's going on, Kent?
She tried to catch my hand in the fridge.
That's rubbish. Look, I'm standing here. She starts screaming or something. You're just trying to get me into...
You're a liar, Jenny.
Cut that out. Now, get back to work, both of you. All of you. Come on, move it.
What's going on? Fighting into factions. We nearly had a full-scale brawl on our hands. I was afraid it'd be like this.
You better report the situation to Mrs. Davidson. I'm going to keep an eye on things here.
You're right.
Now, if there's any more trouble out of any of you, and you'll all be on loss of privileges.
And the ringleaders will go straight to the pound. I could hear the noise from the laundry in the workshop.
But it's all under control now?
Yes, Mr. Fletcher and Miss Bennett had handled the situation by the time I got there. Mrs. Davidson, it's obvious some of the women want to be top dog. Factions are forming.
Well, I'm afraid that was inevitable.
But this could lead to an outbreak of real violence. Officers could get hurt. Therefore, I'd like the male officers from Pentridge brought back.
No, that would only cause more trouble. With Smith gone, it's inevitable that some of the women would want to vie for the position of top dog. You know how important the pecking order is in a prison?
Well, wouldn't it be in our interests to stop any woman becoming top dog? We're supposed to run the prison, not the inmates.
Mrs. Powell, as union representative, I know your main concern is for your fellow officers.
Yes, of course it is.
However, I think you are allowing the recent trouble to make you too apprehensive. The last thing we must do is allow the women to see that we are uneasy.
Mrs. Davidson, how can we help but be uneasy? Once these women are fighting amongst themselves, the next step is to turn on us.
I don't agree. If they are involved in their own power struggle, they're less likely to lash out at authority.
You can't be sure of that, Mrs. Davidson.
No, but from past experience, I would say it is true. Once someone is established as top dog, the women will feel less insecure and will return to their normal routine.
All right. Well, what do we do for the moment?
Just keep them under close scrutiny. I'd like the women to sort this out for themselves. I intend calling a meeting of senior officers this afternoon. We can discuss it further then. Yes. Thank you, Julie. Gaffney has returned from court. Could you process her, please?
Yes, ma'am.
Oh, and Mrs. Powell, would you try not to be too harsh with the women in your attitude? You've always shown them understanding in the past. I wouldn't like you to lose that quality.
Well, all right, move out if you want lunch.
More pig slops, I suppose.
Well, that's what always passes for tackling this bloody joint, isn't it?
Just watch your step, Hazel.
Any more nonsense like that out of you, Brian, it'll be straight to the pound.
Thank you. Stand on that line. Is your name Margot Jane Gaffney?
You bloody well know who I am.
Just answer the question.
Yeah.
You have been convicted on 4 counts of abduction, 1 of armed robbery, and 2 driving counts, speeding and dangerous driving. Also, one count of resisting arrest.
I know the bloody charges. I've heard them often enough.
Now, look, you know I've got to read this out to you. Just answer when you're asked a question. You have been sentenced for a period of 10 years with a non-parole period of 8 years. You understand all that?
Yeah, of course I do. Means I'm going to be buried alive in this stinking place.
Well, you've obviously been made an example of so that others will think twice before trying the same sort of thing.
It won't make no difference to no one else. Only me. 10 years of my bloody life taken off me. 10 years!
It's funny, isn't it, the way some people try and throw their weight around?
Who'd want as much weight as her to throw around?
Yeah, it'll be fun cutting certain people down to size.
Well, some people couldn't cut butter.
Will you just stop this nonsense and get on with your meal? Oh, you can't even pass a remark around here now.
That's right. If you wanted quiet, Vera, you should have joined a convent.
Yeah, can you just imagine? Our Miss Bennett, a nun.
I'll put you all on report if you're not careful.
I'd just see her as a sister of Nancy.
Anybody that she looked after would be glad to die.
Hey, here's Margo.
What'd you get?
10 with an 8.
Oh, that's terrible.
What'd you have, a hanging judge?
Gave me the heaviest sentence he could. Totaled up to 21 years. He even gave me an extra year for speeding.
Oh, that's bad luck, love. Well, you gonna be in on the plan or what?
I'll be in on anything. What have I got to lose?
Good.
Because we're gonna give him hell.
My bloody oath we will.
Oh, just a second, Jim. I'll clear a space for you.
I don't know why I bother, really. I'm not really very hungry.
It must have been hard for you.
What?
The way you've been shuffled around.
Yeah. Governor one minute, then back to deputy the next. Well, I know I was only acting governor, but still I wasn't given much of a chance, was I?
No, I don't suppose you were. But under the circumstances, I don't know what else the department could have done. I mean, the women would only accept Erica.
Yeah, well, that's a bit ironic, isn't it? We had to concede to them. Well, I thought I handled the job pretty well. But now what sort of a hope have I got?
Well, you'll get your chance eventually, Jim. The department must know what a good job you've been doing.
Douglas once told me that he didn't think that I was suitable to be a governor. I haven't got much of a chance with him against me. And now Vera was right. I ought to do something about it.
Are you thinking of resigning?
Well, why not? You did. You got out. You're doing something that you really enjoy doing. Why shouldn't I?
What, are you thinking of welfare work?
No, I want to get out of the system altogether. I want to make something of myself. Well, I've had plenty of experience in other fields. Surely I could put some of it to use.
Yes, I'm sure you could.
Yeah, well, so am I. It's about time I stood up for myself and did something that showed my capabilities. No, I'm going to do something about it, all right.
Whilst I expect firmness from my officers in maintaining discipline, I do not want the staff to lose sight of one of Wentworth's major objectives, the restoration of prisoners to society. To put it bluntly, if they go out of here more hardened and rebellious than they came in, then we have failed.
Surely it's inevitable that prison will harden people. The blame can hardly be laid at our feet.
The whole idea behind imprisonment is the rehabilitation of prisoners. We should keep that in mind.
As long as that doesn't simply mean pandering to the women.
I also think the women should have some of the advantages of the more recent privileges we have implemented.
Which privileges in particular?
Well, I think the conjugal visits should be continued. I also think there should be no wholesale censorship of mail. And I intend initiating the forming of a prisoner's needs committee.
How do you see that working?
As a committee through which the prisoners may express their ideas for a more harmonious relationship between the staff and inmates.
It'll look to them as if they're running the prison.
Mrs. Davidson, as union rep, I doubt whether my members will agree to such a scheme. Well, Jim, what do you think?
Well, I think it's an open invitation for the prisoners to be continually listing grievances and complaints. It can only make our job more difficult.
On the contrary, I believe that if the women feel they have some means of putting across their requests, they are more likely to be manageable.
Frankly, Mrs. Davidson, you make it sound like we're running a hotel where our guests have to be kept happy at all costs. These women are here to be punished.
I have the full support of Mr. Douglas, And if I feel that I am not getting the kind of cooperation from my staff that I need, then I shall be forced to review the staffing situation.
Are you threatening to fire us, Mrs. Davidson?
I am not making any threats, Miss Bennett. I am merely making it quite clear where I stand. It is imperative that we all learn to work together towards the ideals I mentioned.
Well, where are the rest of the sheets? God, you're a lazy cow, Phyllis. You expect me to stand around here all day waiting for you?
Will you get off my back, you big fat dyke?
Yeah, lay off her. Who do you reckon you are, anyway?
She's on the press, isn't she? Doesn't that show who she is?
Hell, it does.
We're not taking orders from you. You needn't think you're top dog.
What do you think you are? You couldn't be top dog in a rubbish heap. Come on, Margo, let's show them whose side you're on. Come over here.
See? She's not going to listen to you.
Of course she is. Come on, Margo, come over here and hurry it up.
I'll kill you!
Gaffney! Break. You started all this, Bryant. Seems to me you got what you deserved. Take it to the governor.
Right, come on, Bryant.
And if you don't want to spend most of your 10 years in solitary, Gaffney, you'd better learn to control that temper of yours. And the rest of you get back to work. All of you.
Bryant started the trouble, Mrs. Davidson. Apparently the other women were working normally, then she started to boss them around and lashed out verbally at Hunt. Gaffney kept right out of it until she had a go at her.
Then you were the instigator, Bryant. I shall have to make an example of you to show the other women I will not tolerate infighting.
What do you expect? You've taken away the only woman capable of leadership.
Regardless of what I may or may
not... The fighting will continue until someone comes out on top. Now, I don't know how long that's going to take, because there are a lot of half-wits around the place and no one capable of taking control.
It seems to me you are merely using the situation to suit your own ends. I will not tolerate that. Perhaps some time in solitary will convince you I mean what I say.
Solitary? I was the one that got clobbered. Margaret went off her head. She just came at me.
Because of provocation from you. Surely you must have realized the stress that Gaffney was under after just being sentenced, and yet you went ahead and put her under further pressure. I am not surprised she attacked you, and I have no intention of punishing her under the circumstances.
That's right. Just stick the boot in me. I'm being got at. Why? Is it because I'm speaking up for the women?
That has nothing to do with it.
I didn't ask for that responsibility. You gave it to me. And now I'm being victimized. I suppose next I'll be shanghaied like Bee was.
That is nonsense, Bryant, and you know
it. Yeah, like hell I do.
As for being the women's representative... You gave me an undertaking on their behalf of good behavior.
I can't control those women. If I do, you come down on me.
Now you are the first to break that undertaking. Because of your actions, I can no longer think of you as anything but a troublemaker. Take it to solitary, Mrs.
If you think that putting me in solitary is going to stop this problem, you've got a second thought coming, because only Bee can
come
do
on,
that.
Come on, Brian, just move it. I just saw Colleen taking Bryant to solitary.
Good. Maybe things will settle down a bit now.
You don't sound very interested.
Well, I won't be around long enough for it to make much difference to me.
Are you seriously looking for another job?
Well, there's not much future for me here with the department against me, is there? May as well get out while the going's good.
Well, with your army background and your experience as a prison officer, you could land a very good job with a security firm.
No, not interested in that line of work anymore. No, I'm going to join the 9-to-5 brigade.
Do you think you could settle down to that?
I don't see why not. I think I could make a pretty good executive with all the managerial experience I've had here as deputy governor.
I think you could do anything you put your mind to.
And it'd make life for you a lot easier without me about, wouldn't it?
I won't deny that I want to get on here. And if you aren't going to be promoted beyond deputy governor, you'll always be blocking my way. If the department's against you, it's best to get out. Best for both of us.
Yes, it's no good me being the dog in the manger, is it?
Well, I'd like to see you get on. I think you've got potential far beyond the job you're allowed to do here.
Thanks, Vera. I haven't found anything that I like yet, but I'll keep looking. That's their knock-off bell. Come on, let's get into it.
You amuse me, Bryant.
Well, I'm glad something amuses you.
Talking about Smith coming back to control things. When are you going to get it into your head that Wentworth's run by officers, not inmates?
You're kidding yourself, you know that. Still, I suppose you'd have to. It'd be pretty hard to stomach your job unless you thought you were holding the whip hand.
You're the one with illusions. Inside. Look, I realize it's hard for you to accept the fact you've got no control over your own lives. But that's what penal punishment's all about. Being deprived of your freedom and made to knuckle under to authority. Now, look, if you could just accept that fact, life would be easier for you.
For the screws, you mean?
You're people who have proven you won't follow the rules of society. Therefore, you've got to be made to follow them. And that's our job.
Judy in the pound.
We've got to keep on with it if we want to get B back.
Yeah, but it's going to be pretty silly if we all end up in the pound.
That's what I reckon. And what about Margo? I mean, she went right off. If we keep stirring, who knows what she'll do?
Oh, she's just upset about a sentence.
Upset? She was more than upset. She was that mad she could have just about done all of us. Mm.
Good, now she's got her gorillas with her.
All right, I got some news. If I'm going to be stuck in this dump for the next 8 to 10 years, I might as well make the best of it. From now on, I'm going to be boss cocky.
Hell, that wasn't supposed to happen.
You got some sort of objection, Hazel?
No, Margo.
Anyone got any objections? All right, well, that's settled. I'm the new top dog, and what I say goes. Everyone understand?
You awake already?
Yeah. Just enjoying the peace and quiet. This place is like a holiday farm compared to Wentworth.
You think you'll stay with us for a while then, do you?
Yep. If I'm left alone, I might just enjoy retiring from the scene as a heavy.
But do you think you could be content not being top dog?
Of course I could. Always liked the country. Yeah, I reckon this might be just the place for me to serve out the rest of my sentence. No fuss, no worries.
That's if you're allowed to.
Why shouldn't I be?
Well, what about Janie and her heavies? Don't they bother you?
They've learned I can give out better than I can take. They won't try that again in a hurry. And Mari and I see eye to eye.
You think it could be all right then?
Yep. I reckon I could really cop it, sweetheart. I've got no complaints. And it'll give me a chance to forget all those years at Wentworth.
Good morning, Mr. Fletcher.
Mrs. Davidson.
I hope it's a quiet day. I have a lot of paperwork to get through today.
Yes, I didn't have time to tell you yesterday. I think things might be settling down a bit. The women have found themselves a new top dog.
Oh, so soon? Who is it?
Gaffney. She came on strong in the recreation room and claimed top position. She didn't seem to have any opposition.
Gaffney?
Hmm.
I would have thought she'd have taken longer to recover from the shock of her sentence.
Well, I got the impression she was working out her anger.
Mm. Well, perhaps it's better that she's doing it this way, otherwise she might have been too difficult to handle. You know, I think now would be a good time to introduce the Prisoner's Needs Committee. If Gaffney can be involved in that, it might give her a sense of having something to say and what's being done.
Oh, I don't think Gaffney would be terribly interested in your committee, Mrs. Davidson. The only needs she's interested in are her own.
Exactly, and her needs are the same as the other women's. Would you bring her to my office? I'd like to have a talk to her.
Yeah, well, I suppose it might do some good.
Oh, I'm sure it will.
Could you fetch Gaffney and take her to see the governor? She wants to see her straight away.
Mr.
Yes, good morning. I'd like to make an appointment to see the manager, please. Yes, my name's James Fletcher. Well, with a view to assessing the kind of work I'd be most suitable for. Yes, this afternoon. No, that'll be fine. 2:15, fine. I'll see you then. Bye.
Working somewhere else.
Yeah, I don't like the feeling around this joint. It's like the calm before the storm.
I know, and Margot's so ratty. She's just as likely to cause trouble just for the hell of it.
Yeah, could turn out to be nasty, I reckon.
Yeah.
Gaffney?
Yeah?
You're wanted in the governor's office.
Guess she's heard the news. Wants to make sure she's on the right side of the new top dog.
You might be able to fool this lot, Gaffney. But I don't think Mrs. Davidson will be very impressed. In fact, she may just take you down a peg or two.
Not me. No one's ever going to cut me down again.
You're all mouth, Gaffney. Time will tell.
Yeah. Time will tell all.
Wonder what old Davo wants her for.
I don't know, but I'm just glad they took her out of this place for a while.
Yeah. Pity we haven't got a bunch of bananas.
Why?
We might be able to buy them two off.
Yeah.
Will she get on my back if I have a fag?
No, she won't care.
Not like old vinegar tits, eh?
No way. The office is here pretty easy going, especially that one. You can get away with almost anything.
Yeah. Well, it's just the way I like them. I was right. I am going to enjoy myself here.
Still reckon she could throw a spanner in the works. We don't want nothing to stop the mushies from coming in.
No, I'm sure as hell don't. Nah, I reckon she'll be right.
Be best to make sure, though, wouldn't it? Why don't we do like I suggested? Be sure to change the way she sees things.
Hey, Tracy! Come over here, I want to talk to you.
I've got a little job for you. It's about your mate from Wentworth.
I would like to start forming the committee as soon as possible. I believe it could serve a very valuable function. What do you think of the idea so far?
Think I'm dumb or something?
If I thought you were dumb, Gaffney, I wouldn't have brought you up here to discuss the matter in the first place. I'm obviously asking for your help with the committee.
I'm not going to get sucked in like that. You can't buy me off that easy.
Buy you off? Why on earth should you think I'm trying to do that?
Because you're scared of what I might do. You know I've been pushed too far. 10 years. Someone's going to have to pay. Everyone's going to pay.
Oh, that's enough of that sort of talk.
I haven't started yet.
If you continue with this sort of attitude, you're only going to make things more difficult for yourself.
Difficult? God, you make me laugh. Things couldn't be no worse for me than they already are.
Margot, I know how shocked you must be at the severity of your sentence.
How could you know? You go home every night.
All you can feel at the moment is bitterness.
Too right.
But this isn't going to help you in the years to come. You need to get yourself involved in something, occupy your mind.
I'm top dog now. I'll occupy my mind with that, getting things done my way for a change, and getting back at the system for what it's done to me.
Oh, there's obviously no point in talking to you at the moment. I'll discuss it with you later when you've had time to think it over.
I've got the next 10 years to think about it, Mrs. Davidson, but it won't make no difference. So don't think you're going to get me jumping every time you snap your fingers.
Would you take her back now, please, Mrs. Barfield?
Whatever it was she said to you, it's upset you.
I told you, she only asked how you were getting on and I said fine.
What are you so jumpy about?
I'm not jumpy.
I'm on lunch duty.
Reckon that's as good as the muck they serve up at Wentworth.
Well, it couldn't be any worse, I'm here to tell you that.
It's pretty awful, Bea. I wouldn't eat it if I were you.
Why aren't you going to be kidding? It's obviously all I'm going to get. Besides, I'm starving. Come on, give. Chart.
She'll change the way she thinks about mushies, huh?
She'll go as high as a kite.
Oh, she'll be begging us for her next.
Rosters yet?
No, I'll do that when I get back. Look, Vera, I might be a little bit late getting back. I've got an interview with a personnel management firm.
What do they do?
Well, most top positions aren't advertised these days. They go through a management consultant firm. And they'll assess my capabilities and try and match me with an available position.
Well, it sounds better than chasing around yourself.
Yeah, and this firm's considered tops in their field, so you never know. They might find something good for me.
Of course they will. You've got the ability. All you need is a chance. And I'm glad that you're doing something about it.
Yeah, well, I better pop home and change. At least I can look like an executive.
Well, I hope they find you something. Although I'll be sorry to see you go. But whether you believe it or not, I really hope you do well.
As long as it's not at Wentworth, eh?
It's not me who's stopping you from doing well at Wentworth. It's the department. And I just hope that you show them how they underestimate people's ability.
Thanks, Vera. You know, this could be the start of a whole new life for me.
I don't reckon they're ever going to see Ben here again.
Doesn't look much like it.
Bloody Margo and her heavies throwing their weight around.
What are you two on about?
Just talking.
About what?
Oh, about this film we saw on the telly last night. You know, with Marlon Brando in it?
Yeah. I can't hardly understand a word he says. Always mumbling, I reckon.
Yeah. Well, you two can stop mumbling too. If you're going to talk, talk so I can hear what you're talking about. Understand?
Yeah, sure, Margo.
Okay, smoker.
You got a fag to spare?
Smoke your own bloody fags.
Oh, I'm running out. Bea always used to give me one when I was running out.
Yeah, well, I'm not bloody Bea, am I? But I am running this joint now, and don't you forget it.
Why'd Davey want you this morning, Margo?
Knows I'm top dog now. Tried to con me into one of her pet schemes. I told her what she could do with it.
I don't know. Some of the things Davo wanted might have been real good, I reckon.
Listen, we're not going along with any of the stuff she wants. All the screws do is give you something and then take it away again. We're better off doing things our own way. My way.
Yeah, but sometimes the things...
What I say goes about anything. The screws don't get no cooperation from us on nothing. You're going to be very sorry they stuck me in here for 10 years.
Hello?
I believe you caused some trouble at lunchtime, Smith.
Trouble? Those...
I won't stand for fighting here, Smith. I know what you're used to in Wentworth, but here things are different. It's time you learnt that.
But I'm trying
to tell... I insist on harmonious relationships, and I don't intend to let someone like you come and disrupt the place.
They doped me. They put something in my soup.
Didn't think you'd be a lagger, Smith.
I don't give a damn about lagging. Not when it comes to drugs. They put something in my soup, I tell you.
That'd be the mushies. Oh, we're not stupid in this place, you know. We're well aware the work parties bring back a type of mushroom, causes hallucinations.
Then why don't you do something about it?
Why should we? Does no harm, keeps the women happy. And that's what we want. A harmonious prison. At all costs.
Don Hughes's name, Jim. Come in. Come in.
Thank you.
Take a seat.
Thanks very much.
Now, tell me something about yourself.
What would you like to know?
Oh, the usual sort of thing. Your age, education, previous work experience, the usual sort of thing.
Right. Well, I'm 35. I left school when I was 16. Had a couple of different sorts of jobs, you know, till I decided what I was going to do with my life. And then I thought I'd try and find a bit of excitement, so I joined the army. Actually, it was pretty dull until Vietnam.
Oh, I can imagine. There's quite a few firms who like men with an army background. What rank did you obtain?
I was a sergeant.
Mm-hmm. And why did you leave the army?
Well, it was family precious more than anything, really. My wife felt that I was spending a bit too much time away from home.
So you're a married man. Any kids?
I lost both my wife and family in an accident.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. Well, you seem to have a good background. What are you doing currently?
At the moment, I'm Deputy Governor at Wentworth Detention Centre.
Detention Centre? You mean a prison?
Yes, that's right.
You're a prison officer?
As I told you, I'm Deputy Governor. I hold a very responsible position there. That's why I thought that an executive position might be ideal for me.
Mr. Fletcher, I think you might be better sticking to the job you've got.
Well, why do you say that?
Well, we've handled a few prison officers in the past, and we find them more or less unemployable. Companies aren't too keen to use a person who's been working in that area.
I can't imagine why.
Well, they think people involved in that sort of thing develop a certain attitude and often find it difficult to get on with other people. I'm afraid I'd find it virtually impossible to find you a company position.
But that's just a whole lot of nonsense.
Well, I wish you'd told us you were a prison officer in the first place. It would have saved us a lot of time. Sorry, but there's nothing I can do for you, Mr. Fletcher.
How'd you go?
Don't ask.
They couldn't find you anything.
They weren't even willing to try. Not once they found out I was a prison officer.
How do you mean?
Well, apparently we're considered rather unlikely people to employ. The bloke I spoke to made it quite clear that he wouldn't have wasted his time on me if he knew that I was a prison officer at the start.
Well, surely they can see that if somebody can hold down a difficult job like this, they can cope with almost any sort of work.
No, that's not the way they see it, Vera. I got the feeling that they think of us as the lowest of the low.
You must have come up against somebody who had a prejudice against prison officers. I hope you gave him a piece of your mind. I certainly would have.
Oh, that'd have done a lot of good, wouldn't it?
Look, don't let this put you off. Try someone else. They won't all be like that.
I've got a feeling they probably all will be. Now, anyone that does a job like ours, they consider as a bit of a misfit, someone who can't relate properly to other people.
That's absurd.
Well, it's not in some cases. But I don't see why we should all be tarred with the same bloody brush.
Now, just keep calm, B. There's nothing for you to get angry about.
After what you did to me?
It was for your own good. We just wanted you to see that the mushies could really be a lot of fun. Then you went and spoiled it all by getting mad. Maybe next time you'll get to enjoy it.
Next time? Yeah, maybe you're right. Maybe next time I should just relax and enjoy it. Could probably be a real hoot.
Well, I'm glad you see things our way. I just wanted to make sure there was no hard feelings.
Yeah. Look, I just want to say... There are plenty of hard feelings.
I told you I wanted to be left alone, and I meant it. Now, giving me those mushrooms was the stupidest thing you ever did. Maybe I will be forced to take over this place. And maybe I should just finish you off properly.
Just enough, Smith, let go of her. I warned you about making trouble, Smith.
I'll get you for this, you bitch.
Her, you should be locking up, not me. She drugged me, and I was just showing her she can't treat me like that.
You should have tried to fit in with the other women, Smith. You're going to find that no one at Barnhurst likes a stirrer. You're in for a hard time from both them and us until you learn to go along with the way we do things here.
Yeah, well, I'll never learn that, and I can handle a lot of them. I'm going to change a few things around here.
From in here? And this is where you'll be spending your time. Until you change your tune.
I won't keep you long. I just wanted to let you know I've decided to do something about the situation with Gaffney.
How do you mean?
Well, it is obvious she has no intention of cooperating with any new measures or projects.
What did you expect? They're not interested in being helped. We can handle Gaffney and her cronies with plenty of discipline.
Yes, I'm sure you could, for a while, and then we would have to cope with more violence. That is hardly the pattern I want to set.
Now, what have you got in mind?
Well, I want to get a more positive reaction from the women. That won't happen as long as we have someone with as negative an attitude as Gaffney ruling the roost. I've thought about it very carefully, and I've made a decision. I'm having B. Smith brought back here.
But that's ludicrous. It will look like a total surrender to the women's demands.
Yes, of course it will. She'll be cockier than ever. She'll think she can get away with anything.
I believe Smith really does have the best interests of the women at heart. I shall explain the benefits of my schemes to her, and I think she really will give me her support.
She never has before. She and her mates just throw your plans back in your face. Why should she be any different now?
Because I think we've all learned some important lessons in the past few weeks. Smith was as shocked as we were when things got out of control. I think she's intelligent enough to want to see a change of atmosphere at Wentworth.
Intelligent? All she is cunning, and she won't be using it to help us, in my opinion.
I'm not interested in your opinion. The decision has been made, and the department is already arranging for her return.
Well, if we're not even allowed to...
We are senior officers, after all, Mrs. Davidson.
Yes, I realize that. And as such, I expect your support, not for you to make things impossible.
Well, I may disagree with you from time to time, Mrs. Davidson, but in the end, you always have my loyalty.
Thank you. I appreciate that. And what about you, Miss Bennett? We seem to be constantly at loggerheads.
Because I believe your administration is too soft. You're always giving the women too much leeway.
And I think your attitude is far too harsh. To put it bluntly, I feel that you may not be as emotionally suited to your work as you may think so. If you cannot adopt a more tolerant attitude towards the women, then I suggest you find some other means of employment. Smith will arrive back here late this afternoon.
Well, Smith, I've solved our little problem. You won't be making any more trouble at Barnhurst.
Oh, yeah? What are you going to do? Stand me up against the wall and shoot me?
Oh, no, it's a little more simple than that. Your type is of no use to us here, so we're going to get rid of you. We're sending you back to Wentworth.
When?
Right now. There's a van waiting for you. You can cause all the trouble you like in Wentworth. Won't worry us at all.
Yeah, well, there are a few bitches here I won't forget. And I'll show them one day they can't drug B. Smith and get away with it.
Won't be much chance of that. You'll never be back here. We wouldn't have you. Now get your things.
Sending that stupid bitch back where she belongs.
Good riddance to bad rubbish.
Sorry about what happened. They made me do it.
Get lost, you stupid little dope pusher. If I ever get my hands on you, you'll be sorry you ever saw those mushrooms.
You can stop threatening people, Smith. Get her out of here.
Yeah, go on, you silly old cow.
Go on.
You should have stuck with us, Smith. You didn't have a good thing when you was onto it.
Yeah, you'll be sorry when you get back to Wentworth. Could have had the easy life here.